Connex talking with James Tolkan, certainly no slacker, from Back to the Future movies, as well as, your career spans a long time, and you've played similar characters, you know, the tough, gruff.
Yeah, in movies and TV, that's a character they've kind of cast me as, and I enjoy doing them. But, you know, I'm a New York actor where I played a lot of variety of roles. And I'm not always the villain, but I enjoy playing them.
You were also in Top Gun.
Top Gun, absolutely.
Are you going to be anywhere in the next one?
I'm not even sure there will be a next one at this point. I mean, after Tony Scott had this recent demise,
right.
I really don't know if there'll be any further Top Gun. And even if there were, I think Tom Cruise would be the only one of the original cast that they would want.
How much of an impact did Back to the Future make on your career? You had a long career before that.
Yeah.
Then after Back to the Future, everybody knew Mr. Strickland and his character and the whole slacker meme kind of showed up.
I know, it's quite amazing. You know, I'm a New York actor, and I worked in New York all those years, and I said I'm never going to Hollywood until they send for me. And then Robert Zemeckis and Bob Gale asked me to do Back to the Future. So I went out to California, and I stayed out, and I did Top Gun and the movies and TV, and I stayed out there about 10 years and had a good time, and then I got kind of tired of it and decided after a total of about 50 years as an actor, I decided I wanted to retire. And although I do jobs on occasion, I'm not going to hang around and do auditions and that sort of thing. I'm living the good life in Lake Placid, New York, with my wife and two corgis and three cats, and I'm just enjoying myself.
So, if you had the chance to do some time traveling, where would you go?
Time travel? You mean anywhere at any time?
Anywhere you could go, just for the historical aspect of it, or to make a change. Where would you go?
You know, I've never really thought of that. There's so many eras in the world that were just fascinating. I'm not sure. I think I would choose a time when art was flourishing, and maybe in Venice or Rome, or the time of maybe Leonardo da Vinci or something like that, you know? That's what I think, yeah.
If you could meet your younger self and give him some advice, what would you tell him?
I would, how younger? How much younger?
I'll let you pick.
Oh, what?
In your 20s.
Oh, in my 20s? Well, in my 20s, I think I made the right choice for myself. But again, these are very serious questions that require serious thought and serious answer. And I find them a little difficult, you know.
All right, we'll let you get back to your fans. James Tolkan, thank you very much
for
your time
today. Thanks for stopping.
All right, you are watching SciFiForMe.com.